See how you feel. Do you feel better? Feel worse? Just feel tired. We've survived our worst day. Let's have a better day today.
What's up, my kiddo? I'm hiding the car again. It's me again. And again, I'm under the light because it's late at night again. And I'm just reaching out to you guys, really, and just saying some of the things that you're probably going through, and just so we can share that same experience. One of the things I'm going through at the moment is one of my best friends was my previous brother-in-law. And, of course, I got married relatively quickly after my wife passed on. It doesn't feel that quick because time goes slower, as we've talked about before, when you're under these intense experiences. But it felt quick to everybody else. And as a result, and because I've had to move countries by accident, I don't know if I'm meant to be here, but that wasn't the plan. We were on a holiday, and I'm an American now, and obviously British. I'm kind of stuck here. And it might be the right thing for us, but anyway, that's besides the point. But I used to speak to my brother-in-law all the time, and he used to come up once a month, or we go down once a month to see each other, and I just don't have that anymore. And that whole side of the family is kind of, they phone and they do things sometimes, but it's not the same. And I understand that, but it doesn't make it any better, and the kids miss their cousins, and it's just a sad thing. And I don't know how to deal with it. I'm sure you go through it, and some of you have it way worse. At first, my father-in-law blamed me for the accident, and that was obviously difficult, but of course it was his daughter. And he wasn't angry to me, but he's not really spoken to me much since, and didn't want to speak to me really. I understand that, and I think hopefully you understood that I didn't encourage that sort of thing, but it's what she wanted to do, and you can never stop her from doing it. But anyway, it gets complicated anyway, doesn't it, after the other one's passed on. So what are your experiences? I mean, I've got it relatively good. My in-laws are still my friends, and I'm hoping to see them again soon. But it's always awkward. And then you've got the other side, which is awkward, which is the new family. And I'm married to someone who's divorced before. And so the person who she divorced, mother, came to her granddaughter's party today. And that was kind of awkward because my kids wanted to be in the photo with her, but she kind of didn't want them to be in the photo with her because they're not really her grandkids. But my mum's passed on, it's the whole story. we're obviously in a different country from my dad. And their other grandma's passed on. Basically, everybody dies around us. It's terrible, guys. Don't hang around with us. And so it's just awkward on both sides. There's like an awkwardness where they're not quite fully members of one family, and the other family's kind of like taking a step back. And then we're kind of separated altogether by geography as well. And so we have reached out to a relative through Ancestry.com who's in the area. And she lost her father when she was 5, and Zephy lost his mother when he was 6. And so they've kind of struck up a like email thing going on. It's quite nice, actually. But yeah, tell me about your experiences with your in-laws. Some of yours are going to be way worse than mine. I've heard of people being cut off, kids being disowned. I've heard of everything, okay? I'm sorry if that happened to you. I have very nice in-laws. It's just that I miss them, and I understand why they're not around as much. And why it's difficult for them. Tell me about yours, guys, and hopefully we'll get through it together. All right, you've had your worst day. Today will be better than your worst day. You got through that one, you will get through this one. Hang in there, guys. I love you. Talk to you soon.